Proszę pan.
Znaczy to twój pierwszy raz w Polsce, jeśli tak, to jak się podoba?
Is it your first time in Poland? And if yes, how do you like it so far?
Yeah, it's my first time, but I still haven't seen so much. I just went to the hotel yesterday and had a sleep, but so far it's okay.
Tak, to mój pierwszy raz. Tak naprawdę nie miałem jeszcze okazji zbyt dużo zobaczyć, ponieważ przyjechałem wczoraj, pojechałem do hotelu i miałem okazję się po prostu przespać. Może dzisiaj zobaczę trochę więcej, ale póki co mi się podoba.
This is one of the biggest bodybuilding events in Eastern Europe. If you could compare this event to the other events, in example, the USA, Western Europe, this is one of the biggest one. This is one of the nicest one for you.
It's a different kind of event because in the other countries they do like expos, and this is like a fitness conference. So the numbers for the visitors are limited here. So that's the difference. So I can't compare them.
Krąży po internecie wiele zdjęć z tobą w roli głównej, ze zdjęciami przed i ze zdjęciami po. Chciałbym się dowiedzieć, która z tych zdjęć jest prawdziwa, ile trwa ta przemiana tak naprawdę. Czy mógłby się oddać te wątpliwości, bo wielu fanów pewnie jest ciekawe.
Well, in the internet there is a lot of photos of you before and after the change of your shape, and they would like to know which one is real one or how long did it take for you to convert in the new you.
But do you mean like now because I was injured or before?
Just in the very first beginning.
In the first beginning, maybe the big change was like after 2 years of working out. But then I stopped competing, so my shape got worse. So then I made a new transformation, and it's like a process that is up and down for me. And then I got injured, then I made a transformation. So that was me for the past 11 years.
Tak naprawdę to jest proces, który cały czas się zmienia. Największa zmiana była po pierwszych 2 latach, później znowu przestał ćwiczyć, na jakiś czas miał przerwę, więc znowu ta forma spadała. Natomiast w zasadzie cały czas idzie to na zasadzie sinusoidy. Raz jest lepiej, raz jest gorzej. Później znowu miał kontuzję, przez którą musiał przestać, natomiast znowu wraca do formy i tak to już jest od 11 lat.
My biggest achievement is getting back from the injuries I was, because like 1 year ago I was on crutches, I couldn't walk, so everybody told me that I will never get back, so I was like disabled, you know. So getting back from this is my biggest achievement.
Pytanie dotyczyło największego osiągnięcia i jeśli chodzi o dotychczasową karierę, to tak naprawdę najbardziej cenię sobie to, że wróciłem do formy, że udało mi się po kontuzji wrócić do tego, w czym byłem wcześniej, zyskać takie poparcie, takie uznanie, jakie jest obecnie i znów ćwiczyć, ponieważ uznawali, że już praktycznie jestem niepełnosprawny, nie będę mógł ćwiczyć nigdy więcej. After how many years? How many years you had to try to work to make it really profitable for you?
It depends on what do you mean, but profitable. Maybe
that you can earn money from this.
Yeah, but it depends on how much money. Yeah. But I can say like at least 3 years, at least 3 years. Yeah.
Lazar, if you could compare the fitness industry 10 years ago and now, do you think that nowadays there is a huge boom about fitness in the whole world? And 10 years ago, there wasn't so many people who were able to train a lot.
Yeah, it's a big difference because 10 years ago, maybe there was only bodybuilding club. There was no fitness guys. And through the social media, fitness guys make a breakthrough. You know, guys like me, guys that was before me. And now there's a younger generation that is coming up. But right now it's very hard to make a breakthrough because there is big competition right now. Everyone has a good body, and there's a lot of young guys that looks perfect. Yeah.
Does improvement in social media helps you, or maybe not?
Yeah, it helps me a lot. Sure, it helps me.
Yeah. But I mean, there are others bodybuilders.
Yeah.
Who also puts their photographs in internet and
yeah.
Doesn't.
Yeah, it's all about timing, because when I started there was no other guys like me, you know, so I was different. Now they are, when I open my Instagram there are like 1,000 guys that maybe some of them look better than me. But there's as I said, there's a big competition right now, so it's very hard to go up.
You started to train when you was 10 years old, from the beginning. You were interested in basketball. Do you still doing other sports than bodybuilding? You know, do you still enjoying playing basketball and watching NBA?
I watch a lot. You know, I'm a big NBA fan, but I don't play because I'm heavy, and after the injuries, I still have a pain in my knees, so I'm not able to play basketball anymore. But I watch a lot. Are you a basketball fan?
Yeah, of course.
What's your favorite team?
Phoenix Suns.
Okay, I was a big fan of Phoenix Suns, but when I was like 12 years old, right now I'm a Cleveland fan. Yeah, I like LeBron James. You don't like it, though?
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
And Lazo, you said in one of the interviews that your shape when you were in the army went so wrong. So if you could say what was the reason that your shape goes so wrong, because you know at the army you have to be in a great shape.
Yeah, I thought that my basketball shape went down, because before I went to the army I was a professional basketball player. Yeah. And for maybe 1 year I wasn't able to play basketball. I was just lifting weights, so my physical shape was good, but I was not a good basketball player. You know, when you gain weight, you can't play that much.
Mm-hmm. And when did you decide to make your whole career connect with bodybuilding?
Because when I was 18, basketball was the only thing I was doing and the only thing I can do. And I got injuries in my knees. So at this moment I decided that I have to change something. I need to start something new, and bodybuilding was the only other thing that I love. So that's how I started.
And why did you love that so much? What did it give you?
It gave me confidence. It may be who I am today. That's why I'm sitting here, because I'm lifting weights. I'm not a fucking professor, you know. Yeah. So that's why I love it. It's my life.
There was a special moment in your life when you decided to be a professional bodybuilder. The one moment, the one event, maybe, I don't know, something's happened to you that you decided to be a professional bodybuilder?
Yeah, because in basketball I was a competitive person, you know? I got used to competing with other guys. So when I started lifting weights, I still wanted to compete with someone. That's how I get to the first competition. But then I saw that I can't earn money from competitions. So I decided to make something different. And I created my website, I made my YouTube channel and everything, and that's how everything went up.
sorry, but if you could compare the Mr. Olympia performances nowadays and 10 or 15 years ago, do you think it's a good way for the best bodybuilders in the world that they are using some inappropriate substances? Do you think it's a good way, or do you prefer to be as natural as it possible?
They don't look good. I mean, I respect these guys, but they are getting too big.
Yeah,
and
their
stomach like this, and that doesn't look good. It's not attractive to people. So 15 or 20 years ago, bodybuilders' physiques was a lot better. Yeah, I know him. Sure, I know him. Everyone that is in bodybuilding or weightlifting knows him.
Zapowiadał miesiąc Mariusz na tym stadionie przed 60 tysiącami stoczy swoją kolejną walkę. Czy kiedyś Lazar miał propozycję może walki w mieszanej sztuce walki?
In about 2 months, Mariusz Pudzianowski will be here fighting in mixed martial arts.
Okay, he's still fighting?
Yeah.
Okay.
And question to you, have you ever tried this? Tak? O to chodziło? Did you have any proposition from to fight or UFC or anything?
I was doing some martial arts or boxing when I was working as a security guard, because you know I was a security guard. I needed to fight, but after that I stopped.
If there would appear a proposition for, of course, enough big money, would you be interested in getting a try?
I don't know. I'm not a fighter. I have to think about it.
Czy tłumaczyć odpowiedź?
Nie.